Welcome to everybody's going to the Rapture. I've always wanted to play this game a while ago. So I don't know what it plays like, but I heard it has a little bit of a story, and it's made by the creators of Amnesia Machine for Pigs, I believe. So let's see. Okay, let me just get started here. Blah, blah, blah. Everybody's gone to the Rapture. Everybody's gone to Hunter's house. It's a blessing for a salesman being able to experience the space. Full scale is something new that we have not had to. It's because they can have such a real reality.
It's all over.
Oh, is it?
Only one left.
Okay. Ooh, very touchy.
I'm going to continue to broadcast for as long as I'm able. If I'm right, you should be able to pick up the signal right across the valley.
Okay.
We don't understand it yet. We're going to keep working to try and understand it. You can use them to find what you're looking for. The answers, they're all here. The answers are in the light.
Okay. What was that?
I'm going to continue to broadcast for as long as I am able.
Good enough. Ballast Observatory.
This is a special announcement by the Emergency Measures Committee. Due to exceptional circumstances, radio and television in this area has been brought under the control of the EMC as per the Crisis Preparedness and Action Bill of 1982. Keep your radio and television on at all times.
Okay, if you say so. What's that? You know what they always say, follow the light.
Serious about this whole quarantine thing. If Mrs. Chalmers I suspect we'll never find her. I'm sure there's something more to
that. What's
that? And Mrs. Chalmers. There's no need. They are so concerned that they are willing to close off the roads. I suspect they'll be arguing that there is a road. What is certain is that for the time being, none of us are going anywhere.
But he had a rifle, a soldier with a rifle, in Shropshire. The world's gone stark raving mad. I've a good mind to write to my MP.
You do that, Barb, and I'll personally deliver it for you, once this blockade is removed anyway. Come on, Barb, I can't spend all day chasing pensioners around the valley. The surgery won't open itself. I need to grab some paracetamol when we get back as well. Fucking headache all of a sudden.
Okay.
Chicken nuggets and french fries for her kids.
astonishing village. Quarantine. Do not attempt to leave, you will be detained. Okay. If you say so. Stars at night. Interesting. Oh my god. This place is big. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
We tried. We did try. But they've closed all the roads and we can't get through it. And then Georgie and Ben said they had headaches. And then they started bleeding. It was horrible. They were so scared. We saw the house was open and I know we shouldn't have, but we just came in to clean up the kids and then he and I started bleeding as well. And it's all over my blouse. Everyone was so tired.
It's alright, everything's gonna be alright. Just try to calm down and tell me where Neil and the children are.
They're upstairs. They were tired and Neil said he could take a nap in the bed. I was so tired, so Neil took them upstairs to tuck them in. I was 6 hours ago. Never came back down. It's been too long. Help me.
Of course I'll help you. Neil? Neil, are you there?
Oh. Neil? What a nice room. Okay. Tickles.
What about the station?
That's shut down too. So there's no way in or out of the valley. They're obviously serious about this food thing.
Phil doesn't think it's good at all. He said he's been practicing medicine for 30 years and he's seen plenty of rumors that this doesn't feel right.
Well, there's nothing of any use on the radio.
Sorry, I'm late, everyone. Have you started?
Yes, but to be honest, there's not really that much to discuss. This quarantine is in place, there's roadblocks and everything. No one really seems to know anything, but people are definitely missing. More of them too, not just a couple of little biddies. No one's seen Sullivan since yesterday, and the house is just sitting there unlocked.
I just got back from the farm. All of Frank's cows died in the night. He's devastated.
Poor man, hasn't he had enough for 1 year? First Mary, now this.
Well, if no one's coming in to sort this mess out, we're just going to have to do it ourselves. Barbara, get Phil to do the stock take on medication. Jeremy, put the word out for people to congregate at the village hall. It's best we get everyone in one place for the time being. I'll organise supplies. We'll have a lot of hungry mouths to feed. There's plenty at the depot, but let's start with what's here in the village. I'll draw up a rota. Charlie, can you help me with that?
Anything for you, Meg.
I'll head out to the valley and scoop up the isolated families. And check in with Lizzie Graves at the camp. Has anyone seen or heard anything from Stephen Appleton or his wife?
Okay. Oh my God.
Loaves and fishes we could manage.
Father Jeremy, might I have a word?
Mrs. Boyles, of course.
See you back at your office. Cheerio, Wendy.
I was speaking to Barbara. She said there was some irregularities about her.
Serious for disease control show in America. Binge drink 17 million drinks a year. The study looked at numbers from 2015. Researchers found that 1 in 6 adults binge about once a week. A binge, by the way, is 5 or more drinks for a man, 4 or more for a woman in a 2-hour span. Binging is more common in adults over 34 and more alcohol is actually consumed by those 35 and up. Binging can be linked with greater risk of cancer, heart disease, and liver failure.
The couple got quite the shock after they allegedly tried to dine and dash at a restaurant in Arizona. The owner of the Tucson bar said 6 people came in for dinner and drinks. The final 2 people in the group got up from the table and tried to leave without paying their tab.
Well, here was a $36 I guess about take the whole day to put away.
The server, though, locked the door and stopped from walking out. The man began to have words with the owner, punching him in the chest. The owner then got stun gun and down went the customer. The suspects are charged with multiple counts of assault and disorderly conduct. The
Tucson police ended up picking up the tab.
Confused.
Patients a mile long down there.
Just send them to the village hall with the others, please.
Well, Doctor, I'm scared. Mrs. Gable just called and said her husband's vanished. She was very frightened. She said there was blood coming out from his ears and his...
What the hell do you want me to do? until they lift the quarantine, we're not going anywhere. Just tell them to drink plenty of fluids, stay warm, and follow the instructions on the radio.
Dr. Pill, please, you have a duty to your patient.
Anyways,
thank you. Just for a few days, yeah. First thing in the morning. You want the kids to catch this clue if it's going round.
It's probably that Father Jeremy spreading it around while he tries to bully everyone into donations for the summer fete.
Seems very quiet in the village, actually, Wendy. Not much bullying to be done.
Oh, Father, I didn't know you were here.
Clearly. Listen, I came up here to tell Amanda that we've had some vandalism in the village. It must be a teenage thing. Tagging, I think they call it. Someone's painting all over doors and things.
Little vandals. Well, I'll tell Neil to make sure we're properly locked up when we go.
For a good man like my God, and these thugs and yobs running around defacing property. He gave a lot to his country, and look what he got in return, nothing but an early death. I look to my birds, Father. Lives lived unencumbered, free and simple. That's as God meant things to be.
Cool.
Contained. not funny. It's serious stuff, and you should mind it. Now then, I'm assuming this is about a point. I am going to the Whistler. My round, I think. I'll not argue with that. Frank, have you seen the sky? It's amazing. Don't think I've ever seen anything like it. I didn't realize we were off to a poetry recital as well, Charlie.
Love.
Terry called this morning. Said there was a problem with Harvey. Said he couldn't get through to the vet, so I said I'd come round and take a look.
There's a problem. I've been trying to get hold of Steve, and he always knows what to do.
Got round here, no sign of either of them.
With any luck, the stupid creature will have run under a car. It's probably rabies.
God.
I told you it would get stuck.
You're just taking the cards. It was a stupid idea.
Moving here was a stupid idea. And I told you, Barbara said they've got balloons. You go and look then.
Wait for that, Harvey. Harvey!
Stephen. He wants to shut down the receiver. Something about instances across the valley. There's intermittent electrostatic discharges radiating out of Tower 6. All of the electrics on the main gate are blown. I'll find time to take a look once the data stream begins to calm down here.
Okay.
see him. Should we go down?
Just leave it. We've got to keep moving.
Sean, we can't just leave him. He must be really badly hurt.
Jesus, Diana, we've got the kid in the car. We should just keep driving.
We can't just drive off. Look, he's there. He's in the car. Oh, he's hurt. We've got to get down there.
It's safe. Leave him. We've got to get out of the valley while we can.
Oh my God, he's trying to enter the seaport.
What?
Yeah, graph paper.
No.
I lost my shoes, sir. There's arches on the green. Take my shoes, sir.
Howard Lantham! You open the door this instant, young man.
I lost my shoes.
Now get up. Get up.
I lost my shoes.
What on earth are you doing here, Howard?
Steve, he told me to stay in case Lizzie phoned.
Stephen, where is he?
What are you doing with those birds?
Concentrate, Howard. Where's Stephen?
He said he couldn't help. He took my shoes, so I'd stay.
Listen to me, Howard Lantham. You find your shoes and you get to the village. Find Father Jeremy, he'll give you some soup or something. Be off with you.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna find my son. Then I'm gonna ask him what on earth he thinks he's doing.
Please.
Rachel, darling, I'm sorry about taping over your music, but we, that is your dad and I, in case you come home, I mean, I know Mrs. Graves is looking after you over there, but just in case you come home, we wanted to let you know we're going to head over to Bart's.
Evie!
Sam, I'm leaving a message for Rachel. Are you going to say hello?
Jesus Christ, Evie, we ain't got time for this. The bloody car won't start. We're going to have to walk.
Sam, shush, it's for Rachel in case she comes back here.
But Charlie says everyone's getting together at the hall. Rachel's at the camp. She'll be fine.
Rachel, darling, anyway, listen, as I was saying, we're going to be at the village hall. We'll wait there for you. I think it's best if you just stay put and mind what Mrs. Graves tells you. We love you, darling. Bye.
You finished? Right, grab that bloody case and let's get moving.
Open. I didn't think Graham would mind.
I'm sure he won't. What are you doing here?
Looking for Stephen, but he just ran out of steam. And the door was open. Have you listened to the radio? I thought I heard him on the radio before.
All over the valley. Don't you get that? This isn't some abstract thing. Whatever came down into the town has got out. They've quarantined the whole valley.
It's right here in the observatory.
It's out in the world. It's adapting and spreading. Do you understand?
No, we can't turn it away.
What's he talking about?
I don't again. If he's on the radio, we can try and reach him on the CB. You go to Stephen's house, and if I get hold of him, I'll tell him to come and find you.
Stephen!
part of these infinite loops. Someone's a nerd. Look. Oh god. Steven was nerding out. Look.
Steven, where's Kate? Are you here?
She went hiding in this hut over here. I guess she locked herself in because she's scared that something might distract her from all humanity. Jeez. It's nice how they put a lot of time and effort into creating this nice visually enhanced game, but it's so slow. I'm falling asleep here and I can't get up. Can we speed things up, you know? Caliendo.
I messed up, Frank, but I've done my time. They shouldn't keep on punishing me.
Some folk won't let go of this, and they've got nothing better to do than to poke their noses into other people's business. Nothing you can do about it,
son. I'm doing a good job. I'm working hard. I swear, Mrs. Grayson will start making stuff if she turns up that person.
Maybe you're right. She's not a good...
Yeah, well, she's not exactly honest with her husband about what she gets up to.
None of that. You're angry about people judging you. Don't be so fast to judge others.
Sorry, Frank.
Keep your gob shut, your nose clean, and your head down. Do you think you can manage that?
Gob, nose, head. Got it.
And steer clear of that Rachel girl. If I've seen you two making eyes at each other, and so's her dad. You don't want Sam Baker coming round after you. Now, pass me that socket spanner and we'll see if we can get this wheel back on.
Oh, God.
$210, so it's very close, and actually all three is focused right on the Pacific, and we are top another title of anime to see it, please. There we go, the category for this one is Showbiz.
Ugh. I swear, this game is making me sleepy.
Telescope in Tower 6 is burned out. The background radiation coming in from the Penrose region is off the scale. It's like mathematics is bending along with the light. Everything is bathed in a strange glow. My face is still numb from the burn.
What is this? Let's go to the bathroom.
England. Can I just stop the train? Stop people travelling about the place? I don't like it, Frank. I don't like it at all.
And nobody likes it. No sense. Sweaty cops over it.
Frank all riled about it, giving me grief. I didn't stop the bloody trains, did I? Did they give me any warning? No, they didn't. Yesterday, it's all like keeping calm now with minor disruptions, and today it's all government edicts and not until further notice, and you'll manage. Half the village has vanished.
The couple of people is hardly half of it.
Now, you forget I've seen it. I was in Falkirk's. Tell you, I got out of the old air raid siren to test it this morning.
Air raid siren? What on earth are you going to do with one of them?
Such a storm.
Thank you. Bloody hell, it's a 12-foot drop the other side of that wall. I'm old, but I'm not useless, now. And I borrowed the ladder.
No one said you were useless. Recently.
I drank.
Let's go in the ladder, will you, lad? It's round the side of the bar.
Would do. Can you be careful? I don't want Stephen Appleton coming mitering round here because you've broken your neck.
Power spiked with the last discharge and then went out again, and I could see the aurora dancing around Tower 6. At the same time, the headache intensified, and I think I began to hallucinate. Old and new memories are clashing and tumbling around me. We're on the cusp of a breakthrough. I can feel it.
Okay.
So he managed to get the
transfer to the observatory then?
Well, this Catherine woman must have swung it. Now he says they're getting married before they come back. It's a pickle. Why can't it just wait till he's home?
You're gonna go?
Goodness, no. We're full of her people. I expect they do things differently.
You wanna wait?
Oh, I don't think so.
When it's been 8 months, won't you just come in and talk?
You would have told my Mary was still alive. You would have charity intent on drowning your sorrows when you should have been at home nursing your wife.
You could be a nasty old bird when you boiled.
Dan Hamilton, you come back here and say that again. Our mother always said you were a bad egg. You'll come a cropper, you mark my words.
I am so bored. No.
Refers to the villain played by Ricardo Montalban.
Damn, quick drop.
Oh my god, this game is big.
There you go.
Oh, thanks, Frank. Let's get it out of the way. I don't know what happened. It just died on me.
Give it another go.
Oh, I only just put petrol in it as well. Robert's taken the other car into town. I wish he'd get back. He promised me that he'd be back this morning.
You think he's off on another bender?
Oh, I can't police him all the time, Frank. He's not a child.
What's going on this evening?
Nothing.
You're seeing Stephen again, aren't you? You two can't keep pithering on like this. If Robert hasn't already worked it out, he soon will.
Oh, not he carries on drinking the way he is. Pardon my French, but bloody shitting thing, why won't it start?
Come on, I'll give you a lift.
Thank you.
Rosie McGuire.
You can't save them. Just pack a case and meet me at the station. They've closed the lines. Weren't you listening to the radio? Because of the flu.
There is no flu, Lizzie.
Oh, Christ, even I'm not stupid. Of course there's no flu, but the stations are still closed.
There's an access footpath that runs alongside the main tunnel. You can get out that way, they won't have thought of it.
You know what's going on, don't you?
You can't use the phone anymore.
Why don't you have using one right now?
Listen, just don't use the phone after this. No TV or radio either. It can hide in the signal.
Oh, you make it sound like it's alive.
I don't think we have a word for what it is. Just promise me, don't tell anyone. Don't quietly meet me at the station tomorrow night.
I feel awful lying and leaving all these people here.
It was a brilliant idea about the show. Tom marks that, you clever thing.
I do, yeah.
And in order to help yourself get over that, you did something.
Yeah, I tried out for gymnastics in high school.
And how did that work out?
I never got over it. I was very happy to be able to do it in high school and college. And I just wanted to manage it. I would help with that.
All right. Rocky, you are in command of the world.
Frank Stryker.
The other crook neck and yellow straight neck are popular summer varieties of this decade. Yes.
Let's talk about
12-letter term for a book produced by adapting a movie script. Peter,
what is the screenplay?
No. Then, what's the adaptation?
No.
Robert,
what is the novelization?
No. Last year,
screen.
Alfred Molina was transformed into this.
I hear a phone.
This adjective is used for a shorter version of a written word that still contains the basic story. What is an original? While many fresh fun varieties are tombstone, the type drive to make these is usually freestone. That is the first phrase. Yeah.
Saturday,
Peter, composer
from
Paris. There's a great day.
I don't even care that he was screwing her. What made me angry was that he treated me like I was too stupid to notice. I dream through the light storm and see the pattern dancing on his skin as he burns. I wake up with eyes full of liquid light. I'm going to concentrate all five remaining towers on the same point in the sky. If it is establishing conduits for communication, that should create a jump in bandwidth.
Jeez.
I think it was instant. I know that's not real.
Even you.
There was nothing we could do. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
I've woken up, baby. Sleep, be wrong.
Rachel, I'm sorry. Sorry.
Hi, this is Kate Collins and Stephen Appleton. Leave a message.
Stephen, it's me. I'm leaving. I've waited as long as I can. If you are there to meet me, I'm leaving for the station now, but I am going anyway, whether you're there or not. I love you. Please be there. I love you.
Is named for a man born in 1871 in Dayton, Ohio.
Thank you.
Yeah, it is. You ever seen anything like it? They must be well happy at the observatory place.
They're probably all partying there right now. This is right, boss.
It is. Right, that's me, short leash.
Kids up bar for night, plenty even.
This is looking at me if I'm gone too long.
Good night, mate.
No, I...
Where am I again? No.
The
mushroom. Oh, God. Jeez.
Mrs. Graves, Sean, baby Dylan, is he all right?
He's fine. Di, come on.
It's okay. Let's get your cup of tea. Mrs. Graves, I need to tell you.
Leave it, Di.
You try and get out of the valley, all the roads are shut
there. I know, I was driving really fast, but the other car was on the wrong side of the road and... Oh, God, thank me.
For fuck's sake, leave it.
It's all right.
Hey, you're all right. Sean's all right. Dylan's all right. That is what matters. Everyone's all right.
Actually, no.
Now I need your help. Some of the children, they're getting quite frightened. So Rachel and I, we decided to push forward the show, keep them occupied. You said the other night you play piano. Can you help with that?
Yes, yes, I suppose so. But Mr. Graves, Rob
can look after himself. He's a big boy now. Don't worry. Just head to the hall and find Rachel. She'll tell you what needs practicing.
Okay, thank you, Mrs. Graves.
Yeah, Sean. Go and find Rachel, please, see if he needs some help.
Of course.
Go on. I am so lost.
No, it's okay. Come on, I promised the kids another shot the last number, then I promised everyone a cup of tea.
I'm very
me? No, I'm not. There's a chance I get him out of here.
It's not working. Oh, really faster.
Don't say that, Reese. She wouldn't do that. Would she? What about Dylan?
She's not doing any jump to the chat. No, she isn't. She's not coming back.
Let her go. She's always thinking of everyone else. There must be something important she needs to do.
Looks like you're in charge now.
So I guess this means we're not leaving, are we?
Spain can wait. Miss Eva, you get back in there. And you meet this, the best bloody people I've ever performed in England.
Promise me you'll come back.
Promise.
Thank you.
very famous place in mythology. All right, we come to you, Peter. We are in first place, according to Dexter. You have 4,000, you said the Minotaur. That was just correct. And that means you're going to lose $39.99. You have a dollar left. Let's go to Dan Lee. He had 6,200. He picked the Minotaur also, and he will lose how much? 6,200. This is shaking up in a wild manner, isn't it? What if Peter would have won with a buck? But why would you say Peter is the space? And we have a correct response. The Hound of Hades, Cerberus, Guardian of Hades. The light given when people came in, he was friendly, but what did it cost you? $1. All right, a wise wager.
Oh my God. I think you're pregnant. Lol.
I found another dead bird over the swimming pool.
What's the fourth one this morning? Did you fish it out?
Yeah. Did you get a chance to think about that pay rise?
Oh, I'm sorry, Reese. You're a bit busy. Oh, Rach, sorry I'm late, Mrs. Graves. I was packing away the tennis thing. Did you check Mr. Paul Shelley again when I asked?
Thank you.
Oh, Jesus. I'll be right back. There's no end to this game. It's making me sleepy.
Where have you been here?
Well, anyways. Looks like I'm going around town or something. Okay, I'm gonna have to just end it right here because I kind of lost. So, stay tuned for tomorrow's live stream, and it'll be something different. Probably Sims 3 or Mafia 2 or 3. Well, depends. We'll see. Okay, have a good night, guys. Peace.